Right, Jimmy, anything you say now can be taken in evidence.
I'm saying nothing.
Yeah, good session there. I know you're not too far off the fight date, but you're looking very sharp. Just tell us about this fight date you've got now, mate.
Yeah, I don't know, Dave's not announced it, but fuck it. It's the 15th of November in Florida, 10-rounder. I've got an opponent, but they're just finalising details and all that. So, yeah, hopefully back end of this week I should get it announced.
It's kind of like, it's fairly short notice, I suppose, but you're always, we've just been discussing there, you're always in and around fighting weight. You don't have to take too much off. But is that why you do that? Because sometimes you might get a late call for a fight?
Yeah, I've known for a few weeks. I'm due a date before the end of the year, and they look at the 1st of November. That one didn't work out, so it's gone to the 15th, so I was already training anyway. So yeah, it just is what it is. Like, I don't want to put the weight on because you've got to get the fucker off, so...
How is it that you manage, because a lot of fighters, straight after a fight as well, or when they've got a bit of time off, they do put on the weight, naturally.
Yeah.
Just because they're not as rigorous with the diet. How do you manage to do that?
Do you know what? I'm not a big eater. I'm just a snacker, me. So, like, I eat more in training than when I'm out of training. Like, I'll be one of them, like, out of a fight, when I'm off my diet, like, I'll have, like, a bit of breakfast, then I'll probably miss food all day, and then I'll get hungry at night and just eat chocolate. So it's not like I'm eating loads and loads and piling it on. Like, I think I've done it for long. I'm 31. I just think there's no point in ruining my body. What, try to keep going as long as I can?
Yeah, yeah. Also, you genuinely don't drink.
No.
And well, you don't do drugs, but like, yeah. So you've never really drank, have you?
Never.
Do you think that's helped you as well, about, you know, in regards to keeping the discipline of the weight?
Yeah, never touched it, never drank. Not that social. Don't
why
like
why is that? Just because a lot of boxers, that's their release.
I don't know, like, just probably personal, like, I don't know, probably like family members and stuff like that, like when you're growing up, I just thought, oh, I'm not going to do that, like, it's probably not the best to do that. And it just stuck me, certain situations stuck me, just thought, it's probably best not to.
Yeah, fair enough. But yeah, so this fight, tell us about the opponent.
I can't give much away about him until he's signed and he's in sorted that, but tough Mexican, 50 odd fights under his belt, I think like 40 plus wins, been in there with a lot of good people, so yeah, good 10 rounds, I'm looking forward to it, I think he's exactly what I need.
No one likes tough Mexicans, who needs tough Mexicans?
Yeah, I know. Well, do you know what, get me revenge over Munguia.
So, I mean, it's a good level opponent by the sounds of it. And, it, you know, is this like a means to an end for you? Is this like something where, you know, is it part of a plan?
You already know anyway, so.
Well, yeah, I know. Lots of questions on that.
Yeah, yeah. There's mention of a big fight afterwards on a big show. Again, like the date until Tyson comes through, Ngannou, like, is what it is. So, yeah, so I fought in Feb and done an exhibition in March. I've been out since. I got married, just wanted a bit of time with my family and that. So finished the year good with a good 10 rounds. And then we're straight into something juicy in the new year.
Yeah, I mean, when you talk about something juicy in the new year, it's a bit, potentially could be a very big fight, especially a big fight for yourself, for family. It could be a life-changing fight, realistically, couldn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Good opponent that they've mentioned. He's obviously got to come through a win first as well. Like, they said he wants one more before he boxes us, so yeah, I'm doing the same. I'm not sitting idle, like, I'm going to get a good 10 rounds in and then just see what opens up.
But yeah, so, yeah, it's all going well. You've got, you're not far away, like I say, 15th of November. It's like a Thursday night show, isn't it?
Wednesday night show. 23 days away, yeah. We are. Yeah.
How can people actually watch this fight?
ProBox TV.
ProBox TV.
Yeah. I think it's free. I think it's free. It used to be like a subscription, but at the minute it's just doing it's for free. So, yeah, I think again, we'll be out there. Four fighting America it'll be on the bounce. So, yeah, it's another good win that'll get another top of the bill. You know, I don't think anyone from over here is doing what I'm doing. Like, they're not travelling around, not topping bills consistently and abroad. If it's not in America, it was the Middle East in the start of the year. So yeah, mate, just keep going, keep being the road warrior.
You do your own thing, really.
Fuck everyone else, mate, do your own thing.
Yeah, that is your mentality,
yeah,
though, isn't it?
Yeah, I just do my own thing. I think I'll just try to focus on what I do and build my own little path, you get what I mean? And it seems to have worked, so yeah, just looking forward to this fight. I was training for the first anyway, so I got good sparring, 2 weeks off, they put it back, so pick me sparring up a little bit now in the next couple of weeks, but yeah, we'll be leaving 2 weeks tomorrow.
What have you got planned sparring wise then? You got some?
We're just starting out now. I know Arnie's on it. We had a change of opponent from the date, so we had sparring suited to one guy, and then it's obviously changed. So changed over the weekend, so we're just getting sorted now. I know Arnie's been on it this morning, so had a little bit of a move around with Frankie before, but we'll pick the rounds. I've got 2 more weeks of getting in.
What's an American fight week like in compared to? What's your experience of that compared to like the ones you've done in England?
Warmer.
Yeah, it's warmer. Yeah, that's one thing.
Yeah, it's just a bit different. Like, it probably can be daunting for people because, you know, they like the home comforts, but I like being away. Like, I've done it now. I've been as far as you can one way to Brisbane, and I've been as far as you can the other way to Los Angeles, so I've been there and I've done it. It's weird because it's like a Wednesday. Like, you've got to tell these bars to finish like 8-9 days before.
Yeah.
So it's not like, the last hard Friday, like it's like a last hard Monday or a Tuesday, fly out. Then I like a good 7 days before with Florida, that's enough for me. First day, I just adapt really, have a bit of a walk, a little sweat out on the pads, couple of hard sessions, and then it's just making weight, press conference, all that shit, make weight, and then yeah, fight.
Well, we'll call this part one because we are going to do more leading up to this fight as well, and hopefully try and get over to see some of your sparring. Perfect. I've got to ask you, about this weekend's proceeding, because obviously we were talking about it this morning. Your former stablemate,
yeah,
Tyson Fury, is fighting Francis Ngannou.
Is that your clickbait fucking thing, yeah?
Clickbait title, yeah. No, I might do it separate. It depends. What do you reckon? Should we clickbait the title about this?
Keep on doing this. You're on views, are you? Pussy and views.
I've lost my train of thought now.
Francis Ngannou.
Yeah, Francis Ngannou. Yeah. It's got a lot of criticism, though, Jimmy. It's got a lot of criticism. You've done an exhibition yourself. You know. What do you make of it?
I think people think he's not a boxer, that Ngannou, but he's a good striker in MMA, and he's unorthodox and he can punch at like mad angles, and he's a big puncher over there. He knocks out a few good people, so it's a bit of intrigue, like, and you know, he's getting a lot of money for it. So I think I said to you in the past, like, he's had criticism since he's been young, Tyson. No matter what he's done, he's been slagged off for it, and I think he's just at that point of his life where he's like, not really, that's what the general public say, as long as I'm happy and I'm getting paid. Like, fuck everyone, which I fully get.
Which is like, similar to your mentality.
Must be in the water, with you, Sean, mate.
It must be with you, Sean, yeah. But like, I mean, I've watched a lot of Ngannou this morning, and yeah, he can definitely bang in MMA. But realistically, yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, you spar a lot of MMA fighters.
Yeah.
Realistically.
This morning, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And, you know, realistically, can they get near you? Like, can they?
Yeah, like, we're sparring Frankie this morning. It's awkward. Like, you don't really throw jabs. They're just like big, like left hooks in. Yeah, you know I mean, and sometimes it can throw you off a little bit. It's a different sport, but I think Tyson's too good. Unless he gets caught with something stupid, and even like seeing an interview from the other day when I think he said to Ngannou, like, I've got a solid chin, you know. Like, even if you catch me, it's not a given that I'm gonna go. And it's like, oh yeah, that's actually true. Like, yeah, Ngannou can knock people out with small gloves on. But so was McGregor, but then remember when Mayweather fought, he was like, yeah, he's got no power. Like, it's different. Like, it's different with your bigger gloves on. You know what I mean? And maybe the ranges are different. Like, maybe Tyson will get to a closer range where he can't, like, have his punches. They'll get the full range of his punches.
Mm.
I think MMA, you're a bit more at distance because you think of kicks and takedowns, aren't you? But if Tyson gets, like, that middle range and he's got no space, like, wind his big punches up, is it really going to matter? I don't think so. I think Tyson boxes the shit out of him.
Yeah.
Gets paid and fair play to him.
40 million, I'm hearing.
That's what I said, mate. Like, why would you be asked about anybody's opinion going, oh, you're fighting this person who's never boxed? Like, I won't care. Like, I know I've had an exhibition, man, I was against a boxer, but he at the time was number one on Box Rec at the weight below Kurbanov.
Kurbanov, yeah. Mm.
But if he said to me, like, do you want to fight? I don't know, he's a good male. He's
like,
a good.
I don't know much about MMA, but like, obviously, like the equivalent of like a super middleweight MMA guy, you for that much money, you
say, yeah, yes, of course, you? Yeah. If yeah. Like Masvidal say, oh, you got to fight Masvidal, you're getting 40 million. I'm like, yeah, and fucking Joe Bloggs goes, oh, it's crap that. I go like, don't care. You get what I mean? I really don't care.
But what do you think about this argument that there's an actual duty as a world champion to fight to try and unify the belts?
Yeah, well, but I don't. I think for me, Tyson, he won all the belts other than the WBC. Got stripped of him. Then he's come back and he's won the other. So he's won them all, just not simultaneously. But it's still like they've still got a lot of hoops to jump through. Like they had the WBA mandatory, which was Dubois. Then they're pulling Hergovic. So it's a lot of hoops to go through. And yeah, and they will turn a blind eye to the mandatories to get this fight done. But again, like it's down to money. I think when you've got that money from the Middle East, everything else is put off. You say, oh, you're going to fight at Wembley, you're going to get 10 mil. And he's like, well, I'm getting 40 mil to fight a fucking guy who's never fought before. So
he probably put a better effort in than Dillian White did. I mean,
oh yeah, dead right.
I mean,
yeah.
So when you think about it from that perspective, I mean, Dillian White didn't even land a punch, did he?
Not really, no. I think, but Tyson's that good. I don't think it was Dillian White. I think he was shot to bits as well. Dillian White. I said he got knocked out by Povetkin, didn't he? Beat Povetkin, who was had COVID or something like that. They rushed that fight through. But yeah, I think they will do it. I know there's conversations had for that fight and the date's thrown around. You know, because I said before, isn't it, like there's talk of me being on an undercard in a fucking great fight. So I know that there is there. And I don't think Tyson was scared of Usyk and vice versa. It's just down to money and business.
Let me just quickly pick up on that. Like, obviously, we're not going to talk. Well, there is a date out there. There is a date out there that people are talking about this Tyson Fury and Usyk. You've had a serious conversation. Nothing's cemented yet, so we're not saying there is. But you've had a preliminary conversation about perhaps being on the undercard for that.
Yeah.
Is that because of the Withenshaw connection with Tyson, or is it just because they're looking for
a bit of both fighters? It come through a Usyk side, like one of his people that are attached to his promotion or his team or something. That came through, and it's a good fight. So, like, yeah, of course, obviously, I've pushed it my side as well. But I think everything's on hold. The kid wanted another fight in the meantime. And now I'm going to obviously do the same. I'm going to keep busy. So it depends when that's done, and obviously the date.
But I suppose as well, like when I mentioned earlier, well, we sort of said it now, haven't we? We weren't going to say it before, but we sort of said it could be a life-changing moment for you, leading up to, because you may be on a massive stage on probably the biggest card of
the
last 10 years or whatever.
Yeah.
And then that could open the gates for you for some of the other big name world title fights we've been mentioning.
Yeah, I'm ready. Like I said, I'm at that age now. I've been all over. I've boxed everyone there to box, and yeah, I'm just ready for those big opportunities now. Just get this one, next one out of the way. Focused on November 15th and then beyond. Yeah.
All right, mate. Well, we'll catch up again. Well, it's got to be within the next 2 weeks, but yeah, we'll catch up again soon.
Total, mate. Thank you.